In the previous session, we have gone through uploading the CSV file into the data frame, how to know the summary structure of the data frame, and how to do a selection or slicing and dicing the data from the data frame. Now, in this session, we are going to learn a two important method to select the values from the data frame. The first is a position-based index, and second is a label-based index. So let us first start with the position-based indexing. So I have the market fact underscore df data in which the data is already uploaded. So here, to have a better understanding, I'm going to park 10 rows into another data frame, which is market fact underscore df 1. So we can do by this way. So there are 10 rows are already parked under market fact df1. So this is also actually a data frame. So now in the position based indexing, we are going to make the use of the function iloc given by pandas. So if we want to select the third row and fifth column, so what happened here is that since this is an index based method, so second is the index, so this is my second index, and fourth column. So my fourth column is 0, 1, 2, 3, and 4. So remember that the column indexing also starts with 0. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. So under sales column, you have to look for the row corresponding to the second index, which is 4701.69. Selecting a single row and all column, so simply you have to specify the index of the row here. So basically it's going to return 012, so third row. The output is vertical here, column and values. You can also make the use of 2, comma, colon. It's going to return the second row. Sorry, it's going to return the third row and all the values under the column. For selecting the multiple row, simply you need to specify the index of the rows here, but then it should be also be like a list. So third, 7 and 8 here. Note, now if you want to select multiple rows, the other way is to make the use of 4 colon 8. Note that 8 is not included. Basically 8 means the 8th record. So we start from the index 4 and 8th record. Now how to do a single column selection? You have to simply specify colon, comma, 2. So it's going to select the third column, which is the ship. So let's see the third column, which here 0, 1, 2. So this is the third column. If you want to select all rows in multiple column, so colon, comma, 3, colon, 8. So it's going to select third column to eighth column. So cust ID. So let's see cust ID position here. So cust ID is 0, 1, 2, 3. So this is a third column. Now if you want to do a selection of multiple columns and multiple rows, how you can do this? 3 colon 6 is going to select from the row 3 to 6, and 2 colon 5 is going to select from row to column 2 to 5. Important point to note here, now 6 here is actually the 6th row, not the 5th level index, not the 5th level record. This you have to note it down. Okay, now the other way and more intuitive way is to make the use of the label based indexing. So that is df underscore loc. So this is a label based indexing. So let me select my market fact underscore df1 data. So now here we are going to select the second row and column sales. So this is the second label here, 2 and sale, which is this. So it's going to return 4701. Fifth label row, market fact underscore df1 loc fifth, which is this one. If you want to select the multiple rows, simply mention 5, 6, 7. Actually, in your real life project, you can make the use of any one of the method, which is more intuitive for you. So now market fact df1 loc 2 colon 5 is going to select 2 to 5th row. So this is also same as the previous one. This is also same as the previous one. Now there might be a certain scenarios where you want to select the particular rows with some filter condition. The way to do is to index the rows with one of the column values. So here I am going to replace this indexing 2, 3, 4, 5 with the column values under order ID. So if you see my output here, now order underscore ID has taken the role of indexing. Now how can I select here? So now if I want to select the rows corresponding to the index ORD underscore 5446, so let's see my output here. So ORD 5446 is what? 1, 2, 3. So basically there are 3 and 4th row. There are 4 rows here. So we're going to select 4 rows. 5446. No, there are only 3 rows. If you want to select based on the index 5446 and you want only 2 columns, ship ID, cash ID, just mention here. Now if you want the multiple rows, so you can mention the index of the rows as a list here, and you can mention sales colon profit. This is useful when in an Excel file you are having a large number of columns and we are listing all the column name is not possible. So you can simply put the start column and end column. So it selects from sales to profit all the columns here also, whichever lies between sales and profit will be displayed here. Now if you make the use of the boolean function, so it's going to return all the rows. So if it is true, it's going to return the first record, true is second, the third record is false. So false it is not going to return. Like 5446 is a false, so it's not returning the 5446 here.